Hey y'all, it's this time of the year again, Operation Christmas Child, and I invite you to pack a box. Samaritan Purse is putting that up every year, and I explain a little bit how it's gonna be. So you go to your church, I think Home Depot has them too, I'm not sure. Home Depot has plastic boxes, but they work too, green and red, and your church probably has them like this, like my one. And you pack a box for a child, or you let me, I'll pack a box for you. See that? It took me a while to understand why there is an alpaca on it. I'm German, okay? I'll pack a box. Okay, so I volunteer there. What is nice, see, this is the label you put on your box. You decide you want to pack for a girl or a boy, then they have three different age groups. I usually pack for the 10 to 14 year old girl. And no liquid, no food, please. You have to make sure, there's a website, you can look it up, make sure nothing like that, or weapons, of course, stuff like that, or that can't go in the box. You get a little, in the box is a little flyer with information. You can look it up. So I put three rubber bands on my box and I show you what I packed in my box. What I also do is I write it on a list. It's kind of helpful. Just in case you are not sure if you should pack it or not, and then you can ask the person who is in the, in the drop-off location. So the way it works is I will be on the 18th and the 19th in the drop-off location. And if you stop by if you want to, and in Gilroy and help. Then once we are done with everything, all the boxes go to San Jose. From San Jose, they go to, I think, Fullerton, California. And from there, they go all over the world. And that little label you put on, with that label, you can track where your box goes. So last year, my box went to a girl in the Philippines. 2 years ago, I had a girl in Costa Rica, and 3 years ago it was a girl in El Salvador. It's kind of, it gives you a little bit of connection to that girl, and in my mind, no kid in this world should go without a Christmas present, and that's why I'm doing that. So look, I'll get you down a little, then you can see what I'm doing here. Do it that way. Okay, so I had rubber bands on it. We do that in the drop-off location. If you have no rubber bands, don't worry about it. We do that usually, but if you have them, put them on, because we have to do that anyway. Do not tape them, because they have to be inspected and we cannot tape them shut. Okay, so this is what I did. I had a little package of girls' feminine product. They're really grateful for that. Then I have crayons, washable crayons. I put in a, that's really important. If you put pencils in, make sure you have a pencil sharpener in there and a eraser, because otherwise they can use it. Because they don't have erasers and pencil sharpeners where they are. I have one in. So I put a blanket in, glow-in-the-dark blanket, a warm blanket. I put sunglasses in a little pouch. A little pet stuffed animal goes a long way, even for a 14-year-old, if you are scared and the world is not really friendly around you. You like to hang on to a little pet animal. That's what the girls, all the kids actually say. Then I have that little magic towel that will come up to towel. I have a few nice hair clips for a 14-year-old. They like to, you know, do stuff like that. I have a toothbrush. Do not put toothpaste in it. We can't do that, but a toothbrush we can do. Little squishy towels. I have hair bands, little pens. Then I have this, it's a mirror with a little brush and like that. It's kind of a, what you put in your face. These are card games. You know, like fish, go fish card games. You see how much I get in that box. So if you pack intelligent, you get a lot in. These are stickers. Every girl likes stickers, and that's a Etch-a-Sketch doodle thing. All of that stuff is from dollar store, not expensive. This is the eraser I found. It's a big eraser. And here I have a diary. I think a 14-year-old girl, they like diaries. And it says, "You are magic." So I put that one in. And that's the empty box. There's a lot of room in there. I found out those two items I cannot pack. It doesn't have space anymore. So what I do is I take them to the drop-off location. And I will donate them, because we pack boxes too. People bring toys and stuff, and we just pack more boxes. So if you have something left over, just bring it there. Don't throw it away or something, okay? We gladly pack a box with it. So now you look how I pack the box. I want to show you how I do it. Oh, very important, I will also send a personal note. Just a little note. I put some of my angel stickers on there. I'm an angel fan. My husband calls it my German Catholic idolatry collection. If angels in the garden everywhere. And I put that in as a little personal note. And now I show you how to pack. Now the personal note is, you don't know what they are have to endure. Where we, these kids have a really dangerous environment. Where we go with these boxes, they need a lot of help. So a personal note, a little pet animal will go a long way, believe me. And these sanitary products as well. So now there's a lot of stuff you can pack for the little, smaller girls, the Barbie dolls, of course, you know, stuff like that. So now I do the flat stuff first. Let's get all the stickers in and the diary. Let's put that one in. Eraser. And now I put, where is the blankie? I put the blankie in right away, because that's the other stuff I can build around. This is the feminine products, they go here. Crayolas. Yes, we wait with that. They go here. That goes here. Squishy balls, go here. The hairband I put in the blankie. That doesn't actually need extra space. Toothbrush. Towel. Did we get that one over here? Oops. Yeah, that works. Clips here. Stuffed animal, that's the problematic thing. But I don't want to leave it out, I really don't. Okay, to squish that one in. Okay, brush goes in. Yeah, that works. Oh, that's my glasses. They don't go in. Oh my God, I would look forever for those glasses again. And somebody who is always losing their glasses. So, see, I show you, I have to write a note. So that will go in too. But for now, I can show you how it looks. And then you put two or three rubber bands around it. That it stays closed. Don't tape it, because they have to inspect it. They have to be able to inspect it at the big location in Fullerton before the customs. Okay, I put three on to hold it up, to hold it in. And it will press down when you leave it. Until tomorrow, it will be nice and flat. Maybe I sit on it. Okay, so now we got the sticker. That goes in, that goes on it. Place your label here, see? See where it says? Place your label here. So we do that. And with that label, I show you again. With that layer, first I put, let me just get a, I could do that later. So I would cross, I would check the girl and the age, the 14 year old, and you see a number there. And when you go to their website and you look up that number, you will see, here, this is what you keep from that label. See that number here? If you put that number in, but give it until January, because it takes a while. As I said, it goes to three different locations before it goes to the children and in all over the world. You know, it goes Ukraine, Philippines, Latin America, all over the world, Mongolia, I know. So it's fun to track it and know where that girl lives that got your stuff. And please don't be that one. Please pack a box and make sure you get together with your church and learn where to drop off the box, okay? And I thank you. If you want to say hi to me, I will be in the drop-off location tomorrow in Gilroy. Not tomorrow, on the 18th and the 19th. I will be there. Okay, bye. I'll pack a box. You too. Forgot to tell you, I will put in the description the address where you can drop it off in Gilroy and the hours when I work there on the 18th and the 19th, in case you want to say hi. Otherwise, if you can't find a church that participates, most of them do, look up the Samaritans Purse website and you will find Operation Christmas Child as an extra link, and you get all the information there. And then you will find the closest drop-off location there. You can, I think you can even pack a box online. You just donate and they pack it for you. That's also possible. Okay, bye.